And lo, vile beasts did rise. Leaving naught in their wake but blood and ash. Sun scorches earth and boils seas. And our sins ascend unto the heavens. Three dooms to unmake all we were.
Sky burns. The final days are truly upon us.
My friends, I trust you have heard the news.
We have. What can you tell us of the situation, Your Excellency?
Last night, the Isle was rocked by tremors. And the earth itself cried out. Aloft, the heavens began to burn. From all about, unholy beasts, the likes of which we had never seen, came forth in fury and rage. No. To say they came forth would be inexact. The people of Razzathan themselves transformed into these baleful fiends. Though the phenomenon was observed throughout our lands, the first creature, the largest and most dreadful of the lot, wrought havoc upon us here in our fair city. Though they bear superficial resemblance to divinities of legend, they are ungodly abominations. The people decry them as blasphemies. The large one's rampage has since taken it to the northern reaches of the island. I mean to dispatch our radiant host in an attempt to quell the threat.
And what of Vritra?
Vritra too makes for the north of his own accord, and yet he knows the blasphemy and its minions were but yesterday his beloved people. His boundless compassion and mercy does not deter him from taking unenviable but necessary action.
Understood. I ask that you allow us to aid you in quelling this threat.
You would risk your lives to help us yet again? I have no words to express my gratitude. Our regiments approach the north from several directions, with a number of units set to depart from the docks of Yedlimat. They will make landfall in an area of dense jungle, where one can expect to encounter dangers even beyond the fell beasts we hunt. I leave you to your preparation. You will find me at the docks when you are ready to depart.
We're as prepared as we'll ever be. Let's go.
friends, heed me. These are children of Fathmir. Forgive me. I could do them no harm. If this is the only way, I shall silence the beasts of the air. Pray continue onward. Thank you. What is this vile presence I sense? The horde draweth near. Be on your guard. Thank you.
As I feared.
What is it?
The beast was there, and now it is no more. Yes?
Indeed. We saw it plain. But you didn't, did you?
I saw nothing. Not the blasphemy that perished here, nor the other men turned beasts. And because of this, I now see all too well. There is no ether. Where the creatures should be, I saw naught but emptiness.
Emptiness? But that would mean...
Recall the words of the Watcher. 'Twas a stagnancy of ether, a cessation of flow, leading to decay and absence, that led the ancients to conclude their star was dying. This is the same phenomenon. The instant these people are seized by the transformation, their ether begins to rot and crumble away like dried mud. Until, from their corporeal forms to their very souls, naught remains.
But the beast spoke with its dying breath. Surely, at least a sliver of the man it was endured.
Mayhap so. But even if the process was incomplete, it was little more than a faint residue.
Gods be good. You're saying they cannot be saved?
Not by any means known to me. Or by any means at all, like as not. For there is naught left to save.
They return not even to the ethereal sea.
Beasts rage on, their hunger insatiable. Even deprived of their master, they perpetuate his legacy of hate. Once proud sons and daughters of Thavnir, all of them, and now I spill their blood.
Vitra, my friends, I am heartened to see you safe. You put your secret at risk. Those closest to me already know the truth, a truth I must now share with one and all. Vitra, calamity has come to Razatan. Our fair nation is rent by screams of pain and despair. More than ever, we require a strong leader to shepherd us through the storm. Reveal your true self to our people, Vitra, and guide us to salvation.
What madness is this, Aiwan? Thou dost forget thyself. Were we to reveal our duplicity, it would do naught but foster confusion and chaos. Nay, I shall remain the Satrap's loyal ally and do battle with the beasts. Easing hearts and leading the people to safety is thy task and thine alone. I ask that you remain at Ahewan's side, and render unto him what aid you may. I know not what lies ahead, but without you, Ra'tetan will not survive.
Take me with you. I am as at home fighting in the air as I am on land. Take me with you.
Were my words unclear? I require no assistance. Thy place is at Arhewan's side.
Estinian, here. The last thing you ever wanted, a link pearl. We'd gain much from knowing your elevated perspective. And it'll keep you from getting lonely, which I know you loathe.
You heard the man. Seems I'm coming with you after all.
Then I pray thy grip is iron. Be it on thy head if thou dost chance to fall.
Fair enough. Now, shall we?
I fear it is as Vitra says. We will not survive this on our own. While I am loath to impose upon you again.
I would insist if you did not. 'Tis the very reason we have come.
Then once more I find myself without words to thank you properly. Let us return to the capital and plan our next course of action.